us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, as we look at your word, even now, I pray what we saw there, the healing, deliverance, and breakthrough that people enjoy, we also will enjoy it today in the mighty name of Jesus. Pray for as many who ought to be here, but for some reasons, they are held down. Holy Ghost, set them free and let them join us sinners in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for hearing the prayers we have prayed. In Jesus' name, I pray. Once again, I welcome you to our night of discovery. The past weeks, particularly last week, we saw how Jesus concluded his teaching on the Mount. And what we saw there, he encouraged us to be the doer of the word. And from that account, we saw that many people followed him because he was speaking with authority. They all confirmed that they had never seen it in this fashion before. Because they said he wasn't talking like the Pharisees, like the scribes. He spoke as somebody who is calling from heaven. And that's exactly what God is doing with this ministry. You will see that we are really different in every situation. We speak clearly to the understanding of the world. And all those who are interested in the truth, they will really recognize that this is not ordinary. But those who don't love truth, I don't expect them to be here. They are to be with the Pharisees and the Sadducees. This church is not for just everybody. It's for only people who really want to obey the word of God and who want to know that God is doing something new in this generation now. As Jesus completed that ministry, he now began to prove himself as God. And that's what we want to study tonight. That's why we're looking at Matthew chapter 8 today. And we're going to consider it 1 verse 1 to verse 4. Testimony. Because when we are respected that with the amount of oil, with the amount of speaking in tongues, with the amount of insect they are using, Nigeria should be a better place than what we have now. Nigeria ought to be a better place than these.
Jesus, as he was coming from the mountain, he said, Jesus, I want you to heal me. Can you heal me? And immediately, Jesus said, yes, I will, and he healed me. Now, I want to explain a lot to you about this healing. Because it's children's prayer, deliverance, healing. You don't need to do any acrobatic, you know, jumping up and down. It's your right. Once you know, God. In that verses 1 to 3, you will see the leper, when he wipes, the Bible says, he worshiped God. And he said, God, will you make me whole?
Don't let anybody deceive you. You know, some of you, the mentality is
draw. Mentality, not the watching. Yoruba. Mentality, Yoruba. That some people have is wrong. That mentality of having somebody claiming to be God, claiming to be bishop, pastor, and then you are kneeling down for him, you are bowing down. That's the mentality many people have there. Don't bring that here. Just hold on to Jesus. And talk to Jesus. Tell him what you want. That's what we are saying here. That's why tonight I'm going to teach you this story on this topic. Jesus healing under the Old Testament. Jesus healing under the Old Testament. You can notice something here that at this time Jesus has not died on the cross. So, when this leper came, he healed him. But when did he heal him? Look at Acts chapter 10. Acts chapter 10. In verse 38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him.
It will be a lot of work.
And it gets you to Nazareth, be a lot of things that a people at Chagara, Lebron, Etion, Kirishio, Inche, Ida, Ufo, and what change you see, follow you, it will be a lot of work for you. The mission of Jesus is to set to relieve everybody of this
problem.
Whether they have gone to the mount, to the cross or not, his mission is to heal people and deliver
them.
And he has not gone to the cross, but the cross that is the purpose, why the anointing was given him, he was healing and delivering people. Today, if God anoints you, Jesus anoints you, what happens? You will deliver. You will deliver. And so, if you come to this church, The anointing Jesus pours on our head here is not for collecting money from anybody. It's not to cheat anybody. It's when you see your brother, your sister going through problems, you rise up and you help him. If you have an anointing that want to cheat, want to collect from people, that's not from Jesus.
So
we want to differentiate this church from other churches in town. Because we have the anointing of Jesus. And when we're in this ministry here, what you will notice, and that's what I'm showing you now, what you will observe is that this ministry, because of the anointing of God, our aim is to heal, to deliver, to make people relieve of their problems. In John chapter 5,
and
it's from verse 1. John chapter 5 from verse 1. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now, there is at Jerusalem, by the sheep market, a bull, which is called in the Hebrew tongue, let's say that, having five portions. In this day, a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, all, withered, waiting for the moving of the water. An angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then that first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. And the second man was there, which had an infirmity, 38 years. When Jesus saw him lie, and knew that there had been now a long time in that cave, he said unto me, without being made whole? Verse 7, the impotent man answered him, sir, I have no man, when the water is troubled, to put me into the pool. But when I am coming, another stopping, stepping down before me. Jesus said unto me, right, take up thy bed and walk. And immediately the man was made whole, and took upon his bed and walked. And on the same day, we look at our church here. We see that the spirit we have. We don't let anybody to be in problem for too long. Because we have the spirit of Jesus. You know, don't get surprised that we are doing what you are doing. It's because we have the spirit of Jesus. Please know that. You know why many of you are surprised? It's not different from what happened to this man here. The Pharisees are just collecting their money.
So when they see Jesus,
they couldn't believe that he can heal them.
Surrender yourself,
the spirit, new spirit will come upon your life immediately. That evil spirit, God will take it away. You have seen them use those churches where you're collecting people money. In fact, I listened to one talking about, you know, what was he even saying? Offering. I don't know how he put it. You know, they're using so many languages to collect money from people, you know?
Now, the mission of Jesus is to give
He cannot wait until he died on the cross before he will begin to heal and deliver people. Why? Because we only have all the power in her and in heaven after he has died on the cross of Calvary.
Jesus, mani agbara lohun ti laye leyin to ba ti kulo mi ke bi
lebu. At this time, he has not given the sacrifice, the ultimate, that is, his life. He has not died on the cross. So the whole power is not totally given him now. And it is his sacrifice, his death on the cross of Calvary, that we put an end to the old covenant. Appreciation, like what they did for him too. Yeah, he can't stop that.
Okay.
Until he died on the cross. Look at what he did again. Because he was still under the law. Here. John 9, verse 1 to verse 7. John 9, verse 1 to verse
7.
And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind on his back. And the disciples asked him, saying, "Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, "Neither this man sin nor his parents, for that the works of God should be made manifest in him." That's what must work the works of him that said, "Why did he day? The night coming when no man can work. As long as I'm in the world, I am the light of the world." When he had not spoken, his parts on the ground and made clear of his speech, and he anointed the eyes of the blind man, which declared and said unto him, "Go, wash in the pool of Siloam," which is by interpretation, said. He went his way therefore and washed and kept seeing. The neighbors, that's verse 7, yeah. And Jesus was believing.
Yes, nothing was done.
Now, look at Jesus spitting on the ground, mixing it with clay. And when he mixed, he put it on the eye of this man. And he said he should go to the river, to the water, to wash. That is the law of Moses. That is the prophetic ministry under Moses' dispensation. And since the law has not been totally removed, he has to obey the law. Otherwise, they will think that he came to just cancel the law like that.
See, oh, he know. See, what she was saying, but when he's having a poor Latin, but of course, he know. Come on, come on, obey. He said, don't want Latin.
So he was trying to tell them that I support the law, at least for now. But when I die on the cross, then I can say, "This is what I want, this is what I want."
We are last of all, we are for what you do not see. She won't be back to the bathroom, so we are for what you do.
So, this prophetic ministry here to use his feet and clay and water, they are normal in the law of Moses.
He shall wash her till you leave me. See, may that you know, that's the top.
And he cannot just do anything different from that under the law at that time. Look at Mark chapter 7, because we are still showing ourselves when he was healing under the Old Testament. Because you see, if you want to be an understanding believer, able to understand the ministry of Christ, both under the law and outside the law. Mark chapter 7. I'm reading from verse 31 now. And again, departing from the coast of Tyre and Sidon, he came unto the Sea of Galilee through the midst of the coast of Decapolis. And they bring unto him one that was deaf and had an impediment in his speech. And they beseech him to put his hand upon him. And he took him aside from the multitude and put his finger into his ear and his speech and touched his tongue. And looking up to heaven, he sighed and said unto him, "Ephphatha," that is, "be open." And straightway his ear was opened, and the strength of his tongue was loosed, and his pain is paid. Play. He under the law.
He was so near that man.
This man was in death.
Yeah, I mean, he was there and he
can hear. But now, because he was still under the law, he performed again as the prophet. He put his hand there, he speak on it, and he commanded, and the man began to hear.
Yes, you got to see my life, you know. All of us.
God gave to him. Look at Luke again, chapter 17. Because I'm telling you what the prophetic ministry of Jesus when he was still under the law. Chapter 17 from verse 11. And
then
for us, as he went to Jerusalem, and he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered into a certain village, there met the 10 men that were lepers, which could have fallen. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when they saw him, he said unto them, Go show yourself unto the priest. And he said to us, that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was cleansed, fall back, and with a loud voice, glorify the Lord who was now. This again are lepers, not one now, 10 of
them.
And he healed them. And he said, Go to the priest and do what the Lord Moses
commanded.
So that they can know that you are healed. So you begin to see Jesus now under the old law, how he performed all his miracles under the law and respected the law of Moses. In Mark chapter 6, his disciples too were doing the same thing that he himself was doing. Mark chapter 6. I read verse 12 and verse 13. And they went out and preached that men should repent. And they cast out many devils and anointed with oil many that were sick. And he then,
once he aligned, what's he more?
Now, it's clear to you and clear to me here that Jesus did not stop his disciples from anointing to heal.
Oh, yeah, or see, you see, you never just could never want to learn, you know, and you want to be for me.
Because it was the Lord there, and since he was doing it, stop his disciples from doing it as well. Now, why did I explain all of this to you like this? Why did I explain it? It's because you see a lot of people today, if you're quoting this Bible, you continue to do all the effort they are doing. And if you say this was did it, just like you have said, and therefore there's nothing wrong in it.
And it just shame now not showing you what it was also good in you.
Go to all these churches, oil, go there, water. So many things that Jesus did here, all of them are still doing it today. Check up everywhere.
I tell money, tear shit, and we're going to be.
mountain, break it.
Worshiping, for some doubted, and just came and spent on them, saying, all power is given unto
and in power, going therefore and teach all men, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever commanded you. This is not what Moses commanded the people. Whatsoever I commanded you, and go, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. You see, Jesus there, he's no longer taking them to the world to obey Moses' commandment.
Yes, you see, for more of my love, man, who of Moses?
You see, now all power is given unto me.
And teach
them what I've commanded you.
When they have come along,
so,
but
you know, when it was so that you know, that you did it according to the commandment of Moses. But that is over now. Carrying oil about, carrying water about. You can tell we are praying and God is answering our prayer. And so please encourage yourself. Those people want to enjoy this ministry. They can't be missing anything like it, except their work really hit that day.
She came to Christ because she has a problem. Now, she's not getting it right there. She eventually finds this place. Now, getting here, what she's hearing is too heavy, too hard, too powerful for her to manage as a baby Christian, the way I would put it, because she's still taking milk. She's not yet breaking bone. Now, she believes that once she is in Christ, she should be living happy now. She should be having money every day. At least everything should be going smoothly. And she is living her life properly, the way she thinks she can do it, so that everything will be coming to her the way she wanted it. Now it's not coming. So I believe that people like that, this church and the teaching have been trying so much to put everybody in the way of Christ and to set everything properly for all believers, for everyone entering in. But I can tell with a look of things that many of us, we are still not getting it, we are misinterpreting it. We are misinterpreting the word we are hearing. Many of us, I don't want to explain myself. So once the message is coming, when most of us hear it, we are not putting it right. We are not getting it right. So, such like that woman. So I just want to make a contribution on that one topic and question that apart from prayer, maybe we should try and reach people like that more to know what they are passing through inside, to understand how they are passing through their life they live day by day. Because she here, we are thinking she's understanding the word of God, but yet she's not getting it. So, I pray the Lord will continue to treat you more in Jesus' name. Now, the one you started for me.
We are through with that now.
I want to add what the message
on the one you are spoken about. Your English is very good.
The preacher preaches sometimes in the church, sometimes in their house.
sometimes in a straight place, that message, and then you
will
be saved. But those evil evils are not taking over. It is the spirit that wicked, the flesh, but at some point when the battle is not much, I want to ask now, devils and anointed in all, made that you are sick and healed them.
What's it, Daddy? What's it, Wasu? Kia? What do you want? What's it? What's she?
What's she? She? Look at Umarai, say that it's idol, insult, idol.